A hunch proves correct. You'll be reaping the benefits soon. A love relationship is imminent. Steve, my main man, looks like you're finally gonna get a date.
How about Capricorn?
Capricorn, the coming week will bring great success.
Woohoo! Guess that means I don't have to study for midterms.
Unless you blow off your anthropology exams and get booted out of school.
Miles south of Garfield. NTSB officials are on the way to the site, which is located in an area of farmland just east of I-5. Airline sources say the pilots may have steered the jet away from populated areas when they knew they were in trouble.
You see, the ancient Greeks were fascinated by the idea of fate. Whenever they had a great decision to make, they'd go here. The Oracle at Delphi, they'd talk to the gods here, find out their destiny. What was their fate? Which brings up the age-old question of free will. Does fate control the choices we make? Or do the choices we make control our fate?
One World Air Flight 528 bound for Zurich reported difficulty only minutes after takeoff. Local recovery workers continue to scour the area, looking for any survivors. But all 252 people on board are presumed dead.
If we have free will, then we control our fate, don't we?
Well, the philosophy majors in here might argue with that a little bit, citing determinism, fatalism, beliefs that state the events that happen in our lives are controlled by an impersonal fate.
In a miraculous turn of events, one man narrowly escaped certain death by walking off the plane moments before takeoff. Allison Bowers has the story.
What do you believe?
I like to believe I'm steering the boat. I like to believe I'm in the driver's seat. It doesn't mean that I don't every once in a while lose focus or concentration, find myself in a rut. But when I do, I like to think that's when fate steps in. Gives me a little nudge in the right direction.
I'm here with Jeff Carter, a man who's feeling very lucky right now. Jeff, you were scheduled on flight 528.
Yes, I was.
But you changed your mind and got off the plane.
That's right. I couldn't take that flight.
Why not?
I had a dream last night that the plane was gonna crash.
You investigate, what did you call it?
Miraculous.
Miraculous
phenomena. What are you doing at my desk?
Oh, sorry, I had an accident with my computer. It's a long story. And I have to finish my paper on maximum entropy and Bayesian probability.
Great. Did you read the paper today? Plane crash.
Yeah, it was sad.
Yeah, everybody died. Except for this one guy, right?
Yeah, but it doesn't count because it didn't actually get on the plane.
Yes, he did. Well, he got on the plane. I mean, he got off, but he got on the plane. He got off because he had a premonition.
The plane was going to crash. I know. People dream about plane crashes all the time, Declan. It means they're afraid of flying. It's called aviophobia.
Yeah, okay, fine, but this one came true.
Yes, because sooner or later, planes crash, and there's usually someone who steps forward saying they had a bad feeling about the flight.
Yeah, but... Well, let's just go check it out anyway. Come on. The paper says you worship Big Ed's Diners down the street. You hungry? My treat. What do you say?
I have to finish my paper.
Come on. Can't type on an empty tummy.
Peggy's busy, huh?
Yeah.
Declan, you shouldn't ride those things.
There he is. That's him. Sit down.
Hi. What can I get you?
I'll have the triple bacon cheeseburger, please, with the works, and extra onions, and chili cheese fries, and onion rings, and a diet soda.
Coming back, huh? I'll just have the spaghetti and meatballs.
Triple bacon cheese and warm some balls.
Warms and balls. Excuse me. Mr. Carter, is that you?
Yeah.
I'm wondering if I might be able to talk to you about that premonition that you had.
Are you guys reporters?
Reporters? No. I'm an anthropologist at the university. Declan Dunn. This is my friend Miranda.
Hi.
Hey.
Anyway, just wondering if I might be able to have a couple words with you. This is something that we like to do. It's like more like a
hobby.
Got a minute?
These look good, man. These are really good.
Thanks. It's the sauce. My special recipe.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You don't mind my saying, food this good in a restaurant like this.
Yeah, I know. I've been trying to get out of here. In fact, that's why I was going to Zurich. My girlfriend's dad knows a guy who's got a 4-star restaurant, and he got me an interview. He even sprung for the plane ticket.
Then you had the dream.
Yeah.
You ever have anything like this happen to you before? Premonition like that?
No, never.
You know, a lot of people saying, this is pretty amazing. Call it a miracle, man.
I don't know why I was spared. And all those others. I just wish I could have stopped the plane from crashing.
Did you tell anyone?
I didn't think anybody would believe me. I told my girlfriend, but she just thought it was nerves. I really don't like to fly.
You remember exactly what happened in your dream?
Everything. I mean, it was like I was really there. I was walking down the aisle, looking for my seat, 19A. And I saw a little girl and her mother. We were on the tarmac for about an hour. And then the pilot came on and he said that there was some kind of mechanical problem. Everything was fine and that we'd be on our way shortly. A few minutes later, we took off. Everything seemed fine. And then I saw black smoke going past the window. And then a huge explosion. And when I came to, there was debris everywhere. Black smoke, fire. Well, I was still strapped to my seat, and it was stuck up in a tree. So I climbed down, and I took a look around to see if anybody else had survived. I couldn't see anyone, but I found a ring, and inscribed on it, June 12th, 95. There's nobody else there. It was so real. Every detail.
Why didn't you just cancel your ticket in the morning when you woke up? Why'd you wait till you went to the airport?
Thought it was a bad dream. And I got my boarding pass and I saw that I was sitting in 19A, and I saw a little girl and her doll.